Divorcing Parents with Children. What to expect at your court appearances before the Portland District Court.
Welcome to the Family Division of the Maine District Court. I'm Family Law Magistrate Dan Driscoll, and I'm going to take a few moments to discuss with you what you can expect from the pre-judgment process in the Portland District Court. This applies to complaints for divorce with children, or petitions or complaints to establish parental rights and responsibilities. These cases typically address one or more issues that may include child-centered issues such as primary residence, visitation or contact with a non-primary residential parent, parental rights and responsibilities, that's decision-making for the child support, division of marital property, payment of marital debts, real estate issues, spousal support, division of pensions or retirement accounts, and other property and financial issues. Each of you have or will receive a scheduling order from the court after the complaint has been filed and appropriate and proper service has been made on the other party. The scheduling order will contain much information that you need to be aware of. Number one, it will tell you when your initial appearance is before the court. It will give you the time and date, and when you get here, you'll check with the clerk and find out which courtroom you need to go to. It will also set various deadlines. Discovery deadlines, that is, the time for which you need to exchange information between the parties. It will also set deadlines to designate expert witnesses if they're going to be involved in your case. It will also give you other dates. For instance, there will be a second court event after your initial appearance in about 150 days. The scheduling order will also tell you which date to come back to court for that day. It will also indicate that through the process, if you do not reach an agreement, you don't reach resolution, and you're asking the court to make those determinations for you, the scheduling order will tell you about which month your case will go on the trailing docket, or the trial list as we call it. Now, when you come to court for your initial appearance, you need to bring a number of documents with you. You need to bring a completed child support act. Also, a completed child support worksheet. The worksheet will indicate what a State of Maine child support guideline order would be. That will be based upon your income and some other expenses. You'll also need to bring with you a Rule 80C financial statement. These documents will all be part of a packet of information that you receive from the court. You'll need to bring proof of your income, such as a current pay stub, an income tax return, or a statement from your employer indicating your weekly income. You'll need to bring copies of existing orders that may affect this case, such as protection from abuse orders or conditions of bail. If those orders exist, you need to bring copies and show them to the magistrate. You'll also need to bring an entry of appearance form. At your initial appearance, you'll have a conversation with the magistrate. At that time, the magistrate will determine, generally speaking, what issues are in dispute, whether they're financial issues, whether they're issues affecting the distribution of property, allocation of debt, child support issues, or other such issues. The magistrate will also determine at that time whether an interim hearing is necessary to establish support, for instance. The magistrate will also determine at your initial appearance whether it will be appropriate to schedule a mediation session. And in most cases, it is appropriate. And in most cases, mediation will take place 3 to 5 weeks after your initial appearance. The magistrate may also enter an interim or temporary child support or spousal support order at your initial appearance. Also, the magistrate may order you to attend a parent education program, such as the Kids First program. There'll be ample time at your initial appearance for you to ask questions about the process. Please remember, though, the magistrate cannot give you legal advice, nor can the court clerks. When you appear at the initial appearance, if you have an agreement as to all issues, and if the 60-day waiting period has elapsed since the date of service, then you can use that date as a final hearing, an uncontested hearing. If you've reached an agreement but the 60 days has not elapsed, then you can come back into the court any Monday, Tuesday, or Thursday morning at 8:15 for an uncontested final hearing. Now, if you do come back for an uncontested final hearing on one of those mornings, you don't need an appointment. You simply show up at the clerk's office and you tell them you're here for an uncontested hearing. Please note, however, that there are a number of documents that you will have needed to complete, and you'll need to provide those to the magistrate. If you have not completed those documents, the magistrate will send you away, and you'll have to come back on another day. The list of documents that you will need is part of the packet that you receive initially from the court clerk. If you don't receive that, you can check with the clerk and you can get a copy of that checkoff sheet. If you are ordered to attend mediation at the initial appearance and you reach resolution after that mediation, then again, you don't have to wait till the next scheduled case management conference. You can come in any Monday, Tuesday, or Thursday morning for an uncontested final hearing. If you do not resolve that, then you will come back and see the magistrate at the case management conference. At that time, the magistrate will have a conversation with you, similarly to the initial appearance, and make some determinations as to how this case goes forward. The magistrate may determine that more mediation is necessary, or the magistrate may determine that it's appropriate to put this case on the trial list at that time. Case goes on the trial list, then your next event will be a trial management conference with the judge who will hear your case, and then trial with that judge. There'll be time at your initial appearance for you to ask any questions that you may have. However, please remember that the magistrate cannot give you legal advice, nor can the court clerks. If you are not represented by counsel, you may qualify for representation by Pine Tree Legal, Volunteer Lawyers Project, or the Cumberland County Legal Aid Clinic located at the law school. If you're interested, you must contact these organizations directly. To make the most of your initial day in court, please do not bring your children with you to the courthouse. Bring all the documents and information requested and be on time. Thank you.
This is a review of the court process. Step 1. One parent files and serves a complaint and other required court papers. Step 2. The other parent may file and serve a response or an entry of appearance form. Step 3. You will both get a scheduling order in the mail. This order sets the date and time for your initial court appearance. It tells you what papers you will need to bring to court. It sets a deadline for filing your financial statement and sets other deadlines and court dates. Step 4. You go to the initial court appearance. Be on time. Be prepared. And bring 3 copies of all required papers. Step 5. At the initial court appearance, the court will hear what your issues are and figure out the next steps in your case. The court will probably order you to attend mediation. It may refer you to a Kids First program, and it may hold an interim hearing on support issues. If both parents agree on all issues, you can go to the court on any Monday, Tuesday, or Thursday at 8:15 a.m. to ask the court to approve your agreement. Before you go, complete the required forms checklist. Both parents must go. You can do this at any time during the court process.